Hello and welcome to EduSathi's lecture on calendars. Now, calendars is a slightly tricky topic, but if you go through this video presentation, I'm sure it's going to be a piece of cake for you. So let's get going. The first thing we understand today is what is a calendar. I'm sure everybody knows that it's a fusion of dates within days. Let's look at the structure of a calendar. We have days. 7 days will make a week. 4 weeks make a month. Now this is not exactly 4 weeks, but 4 weeks plus 2 days, or 4 weeks plus 3 days, generally if we exclude the month of February. Then we have 12 months, which make a year. And then we have a calendar. A calendar is for a year. For example, from 1st January 2015 till 31st December 2015, we will have a single calendar. So this year is also known as a calendar year, which is different from a financial year, which begins in April and ends in March. So the first concept we do in this video is the types of years. First of all, we have an ordinary year. Now, an ordinary year is a year which is not divisible by 4. For example, I have 2002, 466, 1995. All these are not divisible by 4. Now, an ordinary year contains 365 days, which has 52 weeks and one odd day. How did I get 52 weeks? I have 365 days. I divided by 7. So 7 into 52 gives me 364, and I have 1 as the remainder. Now this quotient is the completed number of weeks, and this 1, which is the remainder, gives me the odd day. So in other words, what is an odd day? Odd day is the extra number of days when a number is divided by 7. Now what's a leap year? A year which is divisible by 4 is called a leap year. But we make an exception here of the century years. Century years are years like 100, 200, 300. This is something we'll discuss after we discuss the normal leap years. So a leap year has 366 days, which makes it 52 weeks plus 2 odd days. Because if you divide 366 by 7, you will have again 52 here, 364 here, and you'll have the remainder as 2. So this quotient again gives you the completed number of weeks, and this is the remainder, which gives you the odd days. So for examples of leap year are 1996, 2004, 504, and so on. All these years are divisible by 4. Let's move on to the third type, which are century years. Now if you look carefully, all these century years, 100, 200, 300 are divisible by 4, but all of them are not leap years. So for century years, we have an added condition that the century year must be divisible by 400. So let's recall again, a leap year should be divisible by 4 if it is not a century year. If there is a century year like 1200, 800, 900, it should be divisible by 400. So divisibility by 4 is not a rule here, but divisibility by 400 is a rule. Let's get going to the second concept, that is the counting of odd days. In a given period, the number of days more than the complete weeks, this means that is when divided by 7, because 7 days make a week, are called the odd days. So how do we find the odd days? I have number of days in a period, I divide it by 7. I have a quotient, which is the number of weeks. I have a remainder, which is the number of odd days. So for example, if I have 164 days, I divide it by 7, I get 23 as the quotient plus 3 as the remainder. So I have 3 odd days. Similarly, 147 divided by 7, it is completely divisible. So I have 21 weeks plus 0 odd day. So now let's combine the concept of odd days with the days in a week. So the general type of questions that would be asked to you was, will be,
okay.
So let's combine the concept of odd days with the days in a week. The general type of questions which would be asked to you in an exam would be like, if the first day was a Monday, then what day was it on the 148th day? Now, instead of this first day, they can give you a date like 2nd January here, and here some other date like, let's say, 22nd October. So basically what you need to do is you need to calculate the number of days between these two dates, and rest of the concept would be the same. So let's look at the question at hand. I have the first day as a Monday. I want to find out what would be the 148th day. So I'm unsure about this. How to solve this? You'll divide 148 by 7 as we did in the previous slides. I will get 214. This goes out. I get 8 here. I have 21 and 7. So I have 1 as the remainder. Now this is the quotient, and this gives me the completed number of weeks between the first day and the 148th day. So I have 21 complete weeks plus I have this one odd day. Now whenever you have one odd day, look carefully here, this day would be nothing but a Monday again. Why is it so? Because 21 weeks have been completed. So a week here now starts with Monday, as in the question it is mentioned a Monday, and ends with a Sunday. So I have completed number of weeks which are 21. So I have 21 times starting from Monday and ending at Sunday plus this one day. So the next day to Sunday would be again a Monday. Let's try another question for more clarity. If the first day was a Monday, then what day was it on the 781st day? Sorry for this. So I will again divide 781 by 7. I have 7 ones are 7. This cancels out. I have 81 left. Again, I have 7 ones are 7. I have 11. Again, 7 ones are 7. I have 7. And I have a 4 here. So now, from the first day till the 781st day, I have 111 completed weeks. So 111 weeks which start from Monday and end at Sunday. So 111 7-day blocks. After this 111 weeks, I have 4 extra days. So 111 weeks end at a Sunday. So if I had plus one odd day, it would have been a Monday again, because Sunday plus one is a Monday. If I had 2 as a remainder, I would have a Monday and then a Tuesday. Similarly, if I had plus 3, then it would have been a Wednesday. And since I have 4 as a remainder here, what will my answer be? The answer is Thursday. So this is my final answer, that the 781st day would be a Thursday. So what's the memory tool here? Let's assume that in a question the day is given to be a Tuesday. When you divide the number of days by 7, you will get a remainder which is between 0 to 6. Okay, so if the remainder comes out to be 0, that is, you have 0 number of odd days, the day will be the previous day of the week, that is a Monday. If the remainder comes out to be 1, the day would be Tuesday again, which is the same day. Why Tuesday here? Because here I mentioned that, assume that the day given in the question is a Tuesday. If I have a remainder 2, it would be a Wednesday or the next day. Similarly, for 3, it would be a Thursday, 4, it would be a Friday, and so on. Okay, so for example, you are given that the first day is a Wednesday. Now, what is the 148th day? you will divide 148 by 7, you get the remainder as 1. So 1 means the same day. Here 1 means the same day. So I'll have a Wednesday as the answer. Same day which is given in the question. If I had 149th day, so I divide 149 by 7, I have the remainder as 2. 2 means the next day. So the next day to Wednesday here is Thursday. So answer here would be a Thursday. If it's a little confusing, as we go on and do more practice question towards the end of the video, you'll be through. So let's move ahead. Now we'll count the number of odd days. For an ordinary year, the month of January has 31 days, the month of February has 28 days, March has 31, April has 30, and so on till December. Now if I divide the number of days in January by 7, I get the remainder as 3. So these are 3 odd days. So if I am given that 1st January is a Tuesday, what will be 31st January? So I know that January has 31 days, number of odd days are 3. 1 means the same day, that is Tuesday, as we discussed in the previous slide. 2nd odd day would be a Wednesday, and the 3rd odd day would be a Thursday. So if 1st January was a Tuesday, 31st January will definitely be a Thursday. Similarly, we'll calculate the odd days for each of the months, like March, April, May. It's just the number which comes as the remainder when the number of days in a month is divided by 7, and so on. Now what we have to know here is, for an ordinary year, the January calendar is equal to the October calendar. Now what does this mean? This means that whatever day it was on the 1st of January in that year, the same day it was on the 1st of October that year. How did we arrive at this conclusion? We add the number of odd days and keep on dividing it by 7. So for January, I have 3 odd days. For January plus February, I have the total as 3. 3 plus 0 is 3. I divide by 7. Again, I get 3 as the remainder. For January, February and March, I have 3 plus 0 plus 3, which gives me 6. So I have the remainder as 6. For January, February, March and April, I have 3 plus 0 plus 3 plus 2. This gives me 8 till here. 8 divided by 7 is again 1 odd day. Then I move to the month of May. I'll have the total as 11 here. This is again not divisible by 7. Then I move on to the month of June. I have 13 here. Again not divisible by 7. I move to the month of July. I have 16 here. Again not divisible by 7. Then I move to the month of August. I add 3 more. I get 19. Again not divisible by 7. Then I move to the month of September. I have the total number of odd days as 21. Now this is divisible by 7. If I divide by 7, I'll get 0 number of odd days, the cumulative number here. So what this means is that from 1st January till 30th September, I will have complete set of weeks. Complete set of weeks means that if 1st January was a Monday, then 30th September would definitely be a Sunday. If you even count the total number of days here, if you add this column here, you'll get a number which is divisible by 7. Okay, so this means that the 1st of October will again have the same day as the 1st of January, which is a Monday. So the basic trick here is that you find the number of odd days in each month, add them all up, and then again divide the sum by 7. If the remainder comes out to be 0, then the next month calendar is equal to the first month calendar. Similarly, when you calculate for a leap year, the January calendar will be equal to the April calendar. Let's calculate here. From January till April, what is the sum? I have 3 plus 1, 4 plus 3, 7 plus 2, 9. No, we don't need to calculate this 9. I have 7 till here only. So 7 divided by 7 gives me a remainder of 0. So again, the 1st of April would be the same as the 1st of January and they'll have the same calendar. So just memorize this. For a leap year, January calendar is equal to April calendar is equal to July calendar. Similarly, you can calculate till July. And for an ordinary year, January calendar is equal to the October calendar. Now you have to carefully notice here that April has only 30 days. So as soon as you reach 31st January, there would be no 31st April. Instead, it would be a 1st May. So the entire calendar then gets disturbed and therefore it again becomes equal to the July calendar. Take a second or a minute to recall whatever we have done till now, but I'm sure it would be more clear once we solve questions on this. So let's try the practice question one. If 3rd January 1994 was a Sunday, then what day was it on the 3rd of January 1995? The first thing you have to notice here is that 1994 is not a leap year. So if I calculate the number of days in a year which starts from 13th January 1994 to 2nd January 1995. Now this is one complete year and this is not a leap year. So it means that in this gap, the February of 1994 has only 28 days. It does not have 29 days because 1994 is not a leap year. So what are the total number of days from 3rd January 1994 to 2nd January 1995? I have the total number of days equal to 365. Now when you divide 365 by 7, as we calculated before, this is 52, this comes out through 364. I have one odd day. So the 2nd of January the 2nd of January is the one odd day. So it would be the same day as the day given in the question, which is Sunday. So the 2nd of January was definitely a Sunday. So what would be the 3rd of January? It would be the next day, which is a Monday. Instead of calculating like this, like taking 365 days, you can also simply move from 3rd January till the 3rd of January in the next year. So you'll have the total number of days as 366, which when you divide by 7, you will have 2 odd days. This is 52 here. And 2 odd days, as we discussed in the slide before, is the first day is the same day and the second day is the next day. So what is the next day to the day given in the question Sunday? It is a Monday. So let's look at the next question here. If 22nd January 1992 was a Tuesday, then what day was it on 22nd July 1992? Now the first thing you have to note here is that 1992 is a leap year. So the February month here will have 29 days. Now let's count the number of days from 22nd January till 22nd July as we did in the previous question. So January here has 10 days starting from 22nd to the 31st. February has 29 days, March has 31, April 30, May 31, then I have 30, 22. 22 because from 1st July till the 22nd July. So this gives me a total number of days as 183. Now when I divide 183 by 7, I have 7 2s of 14, I get 43, 7 6 of 42. So I have one odd day or one as the remainder and 26 completed weeks. As we've already discussed, one odd day means the same day as given in the question, so Tuesday. So 22nd July will also be a Tuesday. Now another way of solving this is through finding out the odd days for individual months. Now January has 10 days in the question. So I have 3 odd days. 10 divided by 7 will give me a remainder of 3. February has 29 days. So 29 divided by 7 gives me a remainder of 1. Similarly, March has 31 days. I can divide 31 by 7. This gives me 3 odd days. And I'll have 2 odd days for April, 3 for May, 2 for June, and 1 for July. When I add all these odd days together, I get 15 as the answer. When I divide 15 by 7, I know 7 twos are 14 and I have 1 as the remainder, same as in this case. So I have 1 odd day. So this also gives me the answer as Tuesday again. So the point I'm trying to make here is that either you can add the total number of days in each month and then divide this total by 7, or you can find out the individual number of odd days in each month, which makes the calculation a little simpler. Take their total, this 15, and then divide by 7, you'll get the same answer. Also, the third method, if you remember, we did that for a leap year. The January calendar is equal to the April calendar is equal to the July calendar. So I need not solve all this. I know that January calendar will be equal to the July calendar since it's a leap year. So 22nd January will be the same day as of 22nd July. And simply I can mark the answer as Tuesday. So I've discussed three methods here. Let's move on to the next question. Considering 15th August 1947 as Friday, what day of the week is 26th January 1950? Again, the only thing we need to do is we need to count the number of days from 15th August 1947 till 26th January 1950. So let's start counting. Let's take the year 1947 first. So for August, I have 17 days. This includes 15th August and 31st August. I have 17 days. For September, I have 30 days. For October, I have 31 days. For November, 30, and December, 31 days. So the total number of days for the month, for the year of 1947 comes out to be 139. If you add all these, the number of odd days, you simply divide 139 by 7 and you get here 1, 3, and 3, and you get a 6. So I have 6 odd days for the year of 1947. Let's move on to the next year, 1948. Now 1948 is a leap year. This is a leap year, so that is why I have 366 days. 366 divided by 7 will give me 2 odd days. For 1949, this is an ordinary year, so I have 365 days, or just 1 odd day. And for 1950 till the 26th of January, I just have 26 days or 5 odd days. As we mentioned in the previous question, to make the calculation easier, I'll just add up the odd days here. I have 6 plus 2, 8 plus 1, 9 plus 5, 14. So I have 14 odd days. 14 is completely divisible by 7. So this gives me 0 number of odd days. 0 means that 26th of January will be the previous day to the day mentioned in the question. So the day mentioned in the question is Friday, the 26th of January would be a Thursday. If I had 1 here, then it would be the same day as mentioned in the question, that is Friday. But I have the remainder as 0 here, so the correct option is that it's a Thursday. Let's move on to this next question. Considering 3rd July 2006 as a Wednesday, find what day of the week was it on the 1st July of 2001. Now this is a slightly tricky question because I'm given the day in a future calendar and have to find what day it was in the previous calendar. But the funda would remain the same. We'll first count the number of days between 3rd July 2006 and 1st July 2001. So I'm completing calendar years here. So from 3rd July 2006 to 4th July 2005, I'll have 365 days, because see, now when you can go from 3rd July 2006 to 4th July 2005, what February comes in between? The February of 2006. Now 2006 is not a leap year. That is why I just have 365 here. Similarly, when you move from 3rd July 2005 to 4th July 2004, I will have February of 2005 coming in the picture. 2005 again is not a leap year, so I have 365 days here. Then here I have the February of 2004 coming in between when I go from 3rd July 2004 to 4th July 2003. So now 2004 is a leap year, so that is why I have 366 days in this calendar year. Similarly, you move from 2003 to 2002 and you have 365 days, and then from 2002 to 2001 and again you have 365 days. Instead of adding these huge numbers, I will count the number of odd days. For 365 days, I have one odd day. So I have one here also. I have two here because it's leap year. Then again, I have one and again I have one. So the total number of odd days I have here is 6 days. Now is where you need to pay more attention. I have 6 odd days from the 4th of July 2001 till the time I move to the 3rd of July 2006. So I'll just write a plus 6 here, which means plus 6 odd days in going from this place to this place. Now this is given to be a Wednesday. So now if this is a Wednesday, let's suppose that the day on 4th July was a X day. Plus 6 odd days gave me a Wednesday. So what is X? X is Wednesday minus 6 days before. So this would be definitely a Friday. If you reverse think, if July 4th 2001 was a Friday and you had plus 6 odd days, it would have been a Wednesday on the 3rd of July 2006. So now what I know is that the 4th of July 2001 was a Friday. So then I can reverse track that the 3rd was a Thursday, the 2nd was a Wednesday, and definitely the 1st was a Tuesday. So what is my answer here? The answer is the B part here. It's a Tuesday. The only thing where you can confuse in this question is here. In this equation, I have X plus 6 is equal to Wednesday and you have to find X. So it's a Friday. You have to reverse think that if it was a Friday and I got the remainder as 6, I would mark Wednesday as the answer. Here you have to go in the reverse direction. So we'll just recap what we've done till now. One ordinary year has 365 days, which has 52 weeks plus 1 day. So one ordinary year has one odd day. Similarly, one leap year has 366 days, which has 52 weeks plus 2 days or 2 odd days. So one leap year has 2 odd days. Now the first 100 years have 76 odd years plus 24 leap years. Now remember, it is not 75 and 25. 75 ordinary years and 25 leap years. Why? Because the year 100 is a century year and this is not a leap year. So that is why 100 instead of coming in this 25 goes in this 75 and I have 76 and 24. So if I, for the first 100 years, I have 76 ordinary years. So I'll have 76 into 1 odd days plus 24 into 2 odd days, because a leap year has 2 odd days. This gives me a total of 124 odd days. When I divide it by 7, I'll get 17 weeks plus 5 odd days. This is what I need to remember, that I have 5 odd days. So the number of odd days in the first 100 years is just 5. Counting of odd days in the first 200 years, it would be simply 5 into 2, as I had 5 odd days in the first 100 years. So in the first 200 years, I'll have 5 into 2 odd days. When I divide it by 7, I will have 3 odd days. Similarly, for the first 300 years, I have 5 into 3 divided by 7, which is 15 by 7, or just 1 odd day. For the first 400 years, now this is very important. See, I have written plus 1 in a bold and red here. Why this plus 1? Because the 400th year is a leap year. But 100, 200 and 300 were not leap years. So I have this plus 1 extra for this 400th leap year. So I'll have 5 into 4 plus 1, 21 divided by 7 or 0 odd day. Similarly, for each of 800 years, 1200 years, 1600 and 2000 years, I will have 0 odd days. For every 400 year interval, I will have 0 odd days. This is a very important concept and we will be using widely in the questions that are to follow. So question 1, what day of the week is 2nd October 1869? Now we have to consider that 1st January 1 AD was a Monday. So now this is where we'll use the concept of the century years. We know that 400 years has 0 odd days. Similarly, 800 years also has 0 odd days. 1200 again has 0 odd days and 1600 also have 0 odd days. So I need not bother for the first 1600 years here. So I am left with 1869 minus 1600, or I am left with 269 years only. Now let's leave this 69 years apart and consider this 200 years. Now for this 200 years, how many odd days will I have? We counted earlier, I'll have 5 multiplied by 2 divided by 7 or 3 odd days. Now we are left with another 69 years. But since I have 2nd October 1869, let me calculate till 68 years. Till 68 years, if I divide 68 by 4, I will have 17 leap years plus 68 minus 17, which is nothing but 51 ordinary years. So 17 leap years will give me 17 into 2 is equal to 34 odd days, and this 51 years will give me 51 odd days. So the total number of odd days becomes 51 plus 34, which is 85 odd days. So I have 85 here and I have 3 here. Now let's calculate from 1st January 1869 till the 2nd of October 1869. Now here I'll use a concept which we've done before. Since 1869 is not a leap year, I have the 1st of January same as the 1st of October, because for a non-leap year, the January calendar is equal to the October calendar. So all I need to find out is what is the day on the 2nd of January, because that would be the same day on the 2nd of October. So this is a concept which we discussed earlier. For a non-leap year, these are equal. The January calendar is equal to the October calendar. So let's calculate. I have 85 odd days here and I have 3 odd days here. This gives me 88 odd days. When I divide this by 7, what is the remainder that I have? I'll have a remainder of 4. So I have 4 odd days. Now these are the number of odd days till the 31st of December 1968. So this is a 6. So what would be the 1st of January 1969? It would be 5 odd days. What would be the 2nd of January 1969? It would be 6 odd days. And 2nd of January is same as the 2nd of October. So 6 odd days means starting from Monday. So 1 odd day would have been a Monday, as we discussed before. 2nd would have been a Tuesday. If I had 3, it would have been a Wednesday. 4th, it would have been a Thursday. 5, it would have been a Friday. And 6, it would have been a Saturday. So what is my answer here? My answer is Saturday. This is my final answer. So 2nd October 1869 is a Saturday. Let's move on to the next question. What day of the week was it on 27th March 1967? Now, if nothing is mentioned in the question, you have to assume that 1st January 1 AD was a Monday. This is something you need to assume always. So we'll start solving as the previous question. I will take first 1600 years, the number of odd days is 0, so I'll do no calculations. For the next 300 years, the number of odd days would be 3 multiplied by 5 divided by 7, which is 15 by 7, or just one odd day. Now I've left with 67 days. So I will calculate for the 66 years first. So for 66 years, if I divide by 4, I have 16 leap years plus, because 16 fours are 64, plus I will have 50 ordinary years. So 16 leap years give me 32 odd days, and this 50 ordinary years give me 50 odd days. So the total number of odd days I have up till now is 82, plus the one from the first 300 years, 82 plus 1, which is 83. Now all I need to calculate is the number of days from the 1st of January till the 27th of March. Now 67 is not a leap year. So instead of calculating the total number of days, I'll just calculate the number of odd days. For January, I will have 3 odd days. For February, since it's not a leap year, so it has 28 days. 28 is completely divisible by 7, so I have 0 odd days. And for March, till the 27th of March, I will have 6 odd days. What are the total number of odd days? I have 3 plus 6, 9 here, 9 plus 83 here. So this gives me a total number of 92 odd days. This 92 odd days are from the 1st January 1 AD till the 27th of March 1967. So 92 odd days, I divided by 7. I have 7 ones are 7. I have 22 here. So I have 7 threes are 21. The remainder is 1. So I just have 1 odd day. 1 odd day means the same day as the day mentioned in the question. We had assumed the day. It was a Monday. So my answer here is a Monday. Pretty straightforward now. Let's practice some more questions. If 15th September 1943 was a Wednesday, then what day of the week was it on 19th September 1944? Now we'll move from 15th September 1943 to 14th September 1944. Now this is a calendar year. 1944. The only thing you need to check here is, see if you get confused that this is not a leap year, but this is a leap year. So should you take the number of days as 366 or 365? A lot of people get confused here. Always look which February is coming in between. From 15 September 1943 to 14 September 1944, you will have the February of 1944 coming in between. And this is a leap year, 1944. So this February will have 29 days instead of a 28 day normal February. So this is where the one extra day comes from. So I will not consider 365 days here. I'll consider 366 days here. So from 15 September 1943 to 14 September 1944, I have 366 days, or in other words, I have 2 odd days. This is till 14th September. I want to find out till the 19th. So 19th September, 14 plus 5 is 19. So I'll add 5 odd days here. This gives me 7 odd days. So 7 divided by 7. If I do, I'll get the remainder as 0. So a 0 remainder means the previous day as the day mentioned in the question. So in the question, it's mentioned a Wednesday. So what is my correct answer? It's a Tuesday. So let's look at another kind of question here. Which calendar year next has the same calendar as of the year 1989? Now what does this mean is that, for example, if I take a day 17th October 1989 and I assume that this was a Sunday. Now 17th October in which next year 1900 what would again be a Sunday. This is what we mean by having the same calendar. So how do we solve these kind of questions is we calculate the odd number of days in the year. For example, 1989 is an ordinary year, so it has one odd day. 1990 is again an ordinary year, so it has one odd day. 1991 will again have one odd day. 1992 will have two odd days since it's a leap year. And what we do is we find the sum of these odd days, and then whenever this sum is exactly divisible by 7, then we have the answer to this question, which calendar year has the same calendar. For example, let's solve this question. See, 1989 has one odd day, 1990 has one odd day, so this gives me 2 cumulative odd days. It is not divisible by 7. So I still don't have the answer. I move on to the next year, 1991. It has one odd day. So this total comes out to be 3 till here, again not divisible by 7. Then I calculate the sum for the first 4 years. This comes out to be 3 plus 2, which is equal to 5. Again, it is not divisible by 7. Then I calculate till 1993. The sum is equal to 6, again not divisible by 7. But when I move to 1994, the sum becomes equal to 7. Now 7 divided by 7 gives me a remainder of 0. What this means is that the 1st of January 1995 will be the same day as it was on the 1st of January 1989. So this year 1995 will have the same calendar as of this year 1989, because the sum of the odd days till its previous year, the previous year to 1995 is what? 1994 was exactly divisible by 7. The sum came out to be 7, which was exactly divisible by 7. Therefore 1995 is the year which has the same calendar as of 1989. In the following slides, we'll find out which calendar year next has the same calendar as of, instead of ordinary year, we'll have a leap year. A leap year is something like 2008 or something like 1992. We'll see this in the next slides. The same question, but this year will change. Which calendar year has the same year as 2008? Now let's start counting. 2008 has 2 odd days, 2009 has 1 odd day, 2010 again 1 odd day. So till 2009 the sum is 3, not divisible by 7. Till 2010 the sum is 4, not divisible by 7. Till 2011 the sum is 6, again not divisible by 7. Till 2012 I have the sum equal to 7. So now if you look here, till this I have the sum equal to 7. So 2013 calendar should basically be equal to the 2008 calendar as we did in the previous question. But 2008 year is a leap year and 2013 is not a leap year. So this question becomes even more trickier. because I need to find out that after what year, after 2008, will the sum of these odd days be divisible by 7, and that year also has to be equal to the leap year. So there's a shortcut to this. We just multiply 7 into 4, 4 because a leap year occurs after every 4 years. So it gives me 28. Just add 28 years into 2008 and you'll get the answer. So 2008 plus 28 is 2036. So 2036 will be the same as 2008 in terms of the calendar, and also this is a leap year. So if we have which calendar year has the same year as 1992, just add 28 to it and you get 2010 here. So 2020. So 2020 will have the same leap year, the same calendar year as this leap year, which is 1992. So we've done two types now. For ordinary years, you need to make this kind of a table, form the number of odd days, add them up, and then see whenever it's divisible by 7, the next year has the same calendar year as the year from which we started counting. For leap years, just add this number 28 to the leap year and you'll get the answer. But there's an exception to the leap year concept. Which calendar year next has the same year as 1888? So if we move by the previous concept, I'll just add 28 here and 1916 should be the answer, but this is incorrect here. I'll tell you why. If you carefully notice, I did 7 into 4, 28. Here I assume that after every 4 years, a leap year occurs. Every 4 years. But if you notice here, in the case of 1888, I have a leap year 1888. Then I'll add plus 4. I get 1892. This is again a leap year. Again I add plus 4. I get 1896. This is again a leap year. Plus 4. And I get a 1900. Now this 1900 is not a leap year, because for century years, if you remember, we have to make it divisible by 400. So after 1896, the next leap year which comes is 1904, after a gap of 8 years. So that is why whenever a century year comes in between, for example, in the case of 1888, what you need to remember is you need to add 28 plus another 12 years, which will give you 40 years. So when you add 40 to 1888, this will give you the right answer. So you add 40, you get 1928. This is again a leap year, which will have the exactly same calendar as 1888. So just remember this century year exception and this number 40. Let's move on to the next question. If a leap year occurred after every 3 years and the year 2013 was a leap year, then what day is on the 1st of January 2020? Given that the 1st January 2013 is a Friday. So what we'll do is we'll just calculate the odd days as mentioned here. So 2013 has 2 odd days. 2014 has 1 odd day, 2015 again 1 odd day, 2016 2 odd days because after every 3 years I have a leap year here, then 2017 1 odd day for 2018 and 2 odd days for 2019. So what are the total number of odd days here? I have 4 plus 4 8 plus 2 10. So I have 10 odd days till the 31st December 2019, because I've considered 2019 here. I want to calculate for 1st of January 2020, so I'll just add one more day here. This gives me 11 odd days. I divide 11 by 7, I get a remainder of 4. So I have 4 odd days. Now 1 odd day means that it would have been a Friday. 2 odd days, it means a Saturday. 3 means a Sunday and 4 means a Monday. So the 1st of January 2020 was definitely a Monday. So let's look at this another question here. How many times 29th of a month occurs in 400 consecutive years? We'll consider the first 400 years. Even if you consider the second or the third, it will not make a difference. So now why have they given 29th of a month? This is because if it's a leap year, I will have a 29th February. If it is not a leap year, there will be no 29th February. So basically, what they want us to calculate is the number of leap years and ordinary years in the first 400 years. So let's begin. I have the year column here. I have the leap years and then I have the ordinary years. Now from 0 to 100, I will have 24 leap years and 76 ordinary years. Why 24? Because 100 is not a leap year. It is not divisible by 400. Similarly, from 100 to 200, I have 24 leap years and 76 ordinary years. And from 200 till 300, again, I have 24 leap years and 76 ordinary years. From 300 to 400, I'll have 25 leap years. Why? Because the 400th year is divisible by 400 and this will be a leap year. This gives me a remainder of 0. So when you calculate the total number of leap years, they come out to be 97 and the ordinary years 303. If you add both of them, you have the first 400 years. Now for this leap years, I will have a 29th every month. So I multiplied this 97, the sum, by 12. And this gives me 1164. For these 303 ordinary years, I'll have a 29 only for 11 months because the 29th of February does not exist here. So the total becomes 3333. When you add 1164 to 3333, you will have this as the answer. 4497 is the number of times 29th of a month occurs in the 400 consecutive years. So my answer option is the B part. So let's move on to the last question for the video. If 17th September 2003 was a Wednesday, then what day of the week was it on 21st of November 2008? Basically, what we need to do here is we need to calculate the number of days between this given date and the date we need to find out. From the number of days, we'll find out the odd days and then we will find out the answer. So let's get going with the calculation of days. So the year I've considered here is from 17th of September to 16th of September in the next year because it's given 17th in the question, so it makes it a little easier. So from 17th of September 2003 till 16th of September 2004, the February of 2004 comes into this picture. Now 2004 is a leap year, so February 2004 will have 29 days. That is why here I have written 366 days and not 365 days. The number of odd days, as you know, when we divide 366 by 7 is equal to 2. Similarly, we move from 17th September 2004 till 16th September 2005. Here, the February of 2005 will come into the picture, which does not have 29 days. It just has 28 days. So a non-leap year. And therefore, I have 365 here. Similarly, you can calculate for this calendar year, 17th September 2005 till 16th September 2006. For this another year, till 2007. Now here, I have 366. Why? Because in this interval, I will have the February of 2008. And 2008 is a leap year. So this February will have 29 days. That is why I have 366 years. And this mentions the odd days. Now I'll calculate the number of days from 17th September 2008 till 21st November 2008. This gives me 14 for the month of September, 31 days for the month of October, and 21 days for the month of November. The total is 66, which when you divide by 7, gives you the number of odd days as 3. So let's calculate the total number of odd days here. I have 2 plus 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 3, 10. So I have 10 odd days. When I divide 10 by 7, I will have the remainder as 3. 17 September was a Wednesday. So Wednesday is number 1. Thursday is number 2 and Friday is number 3. So 21st of November 2008 was a Friday. Let's solve the second part now. Similarly, as we did in the first case, I will find the number of days here from 17 September 2003 till 16 September 2004. I have 366 days. Why? Again, because I have February of 2004 coming into the picture, which is a leap year. So 366, which when divided by 7 gives me 2 odd days. Then for this next year, I have 365. Again, I have 365 here. Now from 17 September 2007 till 21st January 2008, I have calculated the days taking individual months. These are the number of days in September. This is for October, this is for November, this is for December, and this is till the 21st of January. So this gives me total of 126, which is exactly divisible by 7. So this gives me the number of odd days as 0. I calculate the total number of odd days. I have 2 plus 1, 3 plus 1, 4 and plus 1, 5. So I have 5 odd days. If the answer was 1 here instead of 5, I would have had a Wednesday. 2 means a Thursday, 3 means a Friday, 4 means a Saturday, and 5 here means a Sunday. I started from 1 and Wednesday because in the question I have Wednesday. So my answer is that 21st of January 2008 will be a Sunday. That is all on calendars.